Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. Today, I bring you a video with the latest updates on the Yuzu emulator for the month. I know I might be a little late, as the progress report came out on the 10th, but due to other major projects, like the RPCS3 vs Xenia comparison, I could only produce this video now. But here I am with all the improvements related to the early access version of Yuzu for Windows, and I'll try to explain them in the most straightforward way possible for everyone to understand. If you're into emulators and want to stay up to date with the latest news as soon as they become available, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for new videos every week.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
One very interesting update is that Yuzu can now run many games without the need for a Switch firmware. The list of compatible games is not yet 100%, but I assure you that most of you have probably had issues with games like Mario Kart 8, which used to freeze when using the Mi selection screen for the first time. Another improvement related to the firmware is that the emulator can now automatically recognize the time zone based on your operating system settings, eliminating the need for manual configurations. This month also brought significant changes in the way graphics are constructed, resulting in interesting benefits for some games. For those who follow the channel and watch the video where I talk about the best emulator to play Pokémon Scarlet and Violet, you know that at the time of recording, Yuzu had better performance but still suffered from vertex explosions, especially if you tried to use the GPU in high accuracy mode. This forced users to keep the GPU accuracy at medium to maintain a visually pleasing experience. However, with the new updates, this issue has been resolved. Now there are no more problems with vertex explosions, allowing the use of high accuracy mode on the GPU if your performance is good enough. Moreover, various minor issues in games like Zelda Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom were fixed. Rain and snow particles have been corrected, providing a better experience for those who seek a more faithful emulation of Nintendo's console. It seems that only a few bugs remain to be fixed. Could we be getting closer to the day when we can use high accuracy mode on the GPU without losing performance? Regarding fast travel in the mentioned Zelda games, particle issues when using this feature have also been addressed. Previously, when using fast travel, particles would stutter strangely when spawning in a new location, but this has been fixed in the new emulator versions, and particles are now rendered accurately. Super Mario Odyssey also received particle fixes, bringing more precise rendering. Additionally, some involuntary eyebrow movements in Xenoblade Chronicles 3 characters have been corrected, and they will now be rendered correctly as well. Another game in the Xenoblade series that received improvements was Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition, where thumbnails that help players differentiate save locations were fixed. Previously, the thumbnails might not render correctly, appearing as black images, but with the new fix, the images should now be saved correctly. Now, here's some good news for users with limited RAM or those using Yuzu on Android. As you may know, running some games at high resolutions may require up to 20 GB of available RAM to avoid stuttering. This is due to how shaders are recompiled, as the GPUs we have are different from the shader type compatible with the Switch. Each CPU thread stores a total of 34 MB in two blocks, meaning 68 MB of RAM for each CPU thread. For example, a Ryzen 3600 consumes 816 MB, while processors like an i9-13900 can allocate an incredible 2.2 GB just for shader translation. This may not be an issue for those with 32 GB of RAM, but we know that most people still have 16 GB of RAM, and on smartphones, the problem is even more critical, as they have about 8 GB and need to share that with the operating system. The improvements in the shader system were truly impressive, reducing memory consumption from 68 MB to only 134 KB, which represents a reduction of 99.6%. This is excellent news for users with limited RAM or those using the emulator on Android, as it will now be much more feasible to run games at high resolutions. Another important fix was related to the anisotropic filtering, which was causing problems in some games like Fire Emblem Three Houses, Astral Chain, Metroid Prime Remastered, Zelda Breath of the Wild, and Tears of the Kingdom. Now, with this correction, anisotropic filtering should work correctly in all these games, improving the sharpness of textures at different distances and angles for objects. The problem with Unreal Engine 4 has also been addressed, resolving issues of missing or broken textures in games like Shin Megami Tensei 5, Bravely Default, Pikmin 4, and Metroid Prime Remaster. These issues only occurred when using the Vulkan API, and now the emulator will prefer VRAM to process these textures, which should make most games produced in Unreal Engine 4 more stable. However, it's important to note that this fix may lead to increased VRAM consumption, which could cause problems on low-performance GPUs with dedicated VRAM, like in the case of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom with 4GB of VRAM. So, there might be a performance cost for some games, but it is believed that the benefit of having stable gameplay across a wide range of games outweighs these performance drops in the latest Zelda on GPUs with limited VRAM. During testing, it was discovered that any resolution scaling mod above 1080p would cause issues with ambient occlusion effects when scaled above 1x resolution in Tears of the Kingdom. However, with the new improvement, the game can now be safely scaled using mods to achieve the actual 1080p resolution and then be resized to any desired resolution using Yuzu's internal resolution scaler. Another significant change was the reduction in API calls the emulator made to render each frame, which fixed bugs and improved performance in some games. In tests with a Ryzen 5 5600X running Tears of the Kingdom, the performance gain was 17%, and on a more powerful CPU, the gains are likely to be even higher. Resolution scaling bugs were fixed, mainly affecting Crysis Remaster and Titan Quest. Yuzu joked that it can now run Crysis in 4K, referring to an old meme that said that if your PC was good enough, it could run Crysis at max settings. There were performance gains with the OpenGL API, with an exclusive gain for Nvidia cards that can double the performance, but overall, there is an increase of 2-10%. A problem with anti-aliasing was also fixed, which, when using FXAA, caused textures to display colors different from what they should. Furthermore, an option to synchronize audio and video when using any dynamic FPS mods during gameplay was added. By enabling the option, sync to frame rate of video playback, the audio won't be delayed when using dynamic FPS mods or pressing Ctrl-U on the emulator. In addition, there were several updates related to the Linux and Android versions, but since I don't have the means to test and talk about them, I'll leave the link in the description for you to check out. I hope these updates were helpful to you. See you in the next video.